I tried to get you in D.C. to tell me about it. You couldn't tell me anything was official then. Then during the draft, it was still being kept hush-hush. But finally, the XFL footballs are public. We could talk about everything that went into them. Man, I'm so hyped for this.
Yeah, it's exciting. I remember having to hide all the balls as people were coming into the office. So my desk normally has about 12 balls on it, but had to hide them in Doug's office.
Yeah, we were saying, what's behind that? What's under that giant sheet in that office, Brian? I remember saying that when we walked in.
Right.
Well, Brian, start us off here, man, because we got to know every detail about these footballs because they look amazing.
There's some great videos out there, Sam, right now, right, of all the different technology, but we want to hear from you. Just tell us, you know, really, what are the main physical features that separate this ball from what other balls that we're used to seeing in the sport of football?
So first and foremost, our ball covers the same dimensions as a standard NFL football, professional football. So it's dimensions-wise, it's the same. It's the same leather that you'll see in an NFL football, same leather you'll see in professional football and collegiate football. So from a basic performance component standpoint, it's the same. How we modify that is a little bit different. The most recognizable feature is going to be the X tips, or the tips of the ball with an X on it, that white piece on the end. That was a design idea. We had about 50 of them come across our desk in football ops, and we're looking at different pieces of what we could do with the ball, and then we would be there to say, does this help or hurt the player when they use it? And so we actually didn't know if it would help or hurt the player. And then when we finally tested it at the showcases, because there actually was a lot of hard work that went into making sure that one worked as well. The X Pebbling, which we'll get to later, you know, that one clearly was very hard. But actually creating stripes that go on the tip of the ball compared to the stripes on the sides of the ball or around the circumference of the ball, that was harder to do than people may think. And Big Game and Team Issue did a great job putting that together. So that's probably the first and foremost. The next one is the X Pebbling, which was a really an idea that came to us outside of design firm. I hadn't really thought about it, but came to us when Bobby Monica and I, he's our league equipment manager. He's been around the block. Awesome guy. Been around forever in the football world. We were at the AFCA talking with all the ball manufacturers, and Team Issue and Chris Calandro came up to us, and we were talking about it, and they actually showed us an SMU autograph ball that had really large indentations and extrusions coming out of it. And that kind of made the idea, oh, you could manipulate leather in unique ways, and they were the only ones doing it in unique ways. And so that's where the idea of creating an interconnecting XFL X logo into it. And so that's where we thought about it. Again, we didn't want performance to suffer from when we modify the ball. So players need to be able to catch the ball. Players need to be able to throw the ball. Yes, players need to snap the ball. It's still very important to us. Not as important as throwing and pass catching, but the center matters. and we wanted to make sure it didn't get affected too much. So we tried a lot of different sizes as well, but we ended up with the standard size. It's this size for a reason, the ball, and it's because players like to catch the fat of the ball. We tried a narrower ball that fluttered in the air. Shorter balls don't give as much circumference or give as much area to catch the ball. So that's where we came into this solid piece, solid ball we have now, and settled into the sizing of it. Another piece is that our ball, the bladder, is unique to what Team Issue does is, the top of the ball and the bottom of the ball are balanced. When you add the laces, you get an imbalanced ball. And so it's harder to throw a tighter spiral. So our ball spirals a little bit nicer based on how we've balanced it.
And I think it's going to look really cool with the spiral with that X tip too, Sam. And I love how you guys really focused on function. You want it to look cool, but function is so important. And these balls are looking like they're going to benefit the players a little bit. Tell us about those X tips, because those should help wide receivers maybe locate balls better, huh?
Yeah, when we saw the design, it reminded us a lot in the football ops department of the practice balls that wide receivers will have. In high school, we had balls that had on the four panels on the tips of the ball, there'd be a green one, a red two, a blue 3 and a yellow 4. And when you throw the ball, the coach would yell color or number, and you had to look it in. You would say what was on top. You know, if it was color, you'd say yellow. If it was number, you'd say 4. And right, that was part of it. And so this was a way to look the ball in, and this gave us that piece that you track the ball in the air. So we wanted to make sure that that was the visual part of it. And so as you'll see when we have the 18 balls, we had thought process on having it be all team colors, the stripes, the laces, everything be team colors. But we then thought if we do it so unique, every team will have to have every set of balls because the Vipers will punt a Vipers ball to a Battlehawks returner. So we didn't want to have to create brand new balls for everybody on every team to where you'd have to have every set there and practice with every set. So when the ball's spinning, you'll be able to track the white part of the ball. Every ball has the same whites so that we don't have to have cross-functionally around all the teams.
Well, Sam, you mentioned a little bit about the teams having their own balls. What went into the process of doing that and letting teams kind of have their own colors on the ball while they're on offense?
So pulling back of the curtain, every team has had their own balls in college football, professional football. That's just something we wanted to showcase that. You'll even see in college football, some teams will use a Nike ball and then another team will use a Wilson ball within the same game. Right. Fans may not notice that, but so we just wanted to kind of put that at the forefront that lets fans be able to have and see their own, their team's football. And that team will be able to have, they'll have 12 footballs they'll bring to each game. That'll be prepped for them to be able to use throughout the game, and thought, okay, this is kind of putting into the forefront, letting fans a little in on the little secret of the football industry.
Well, Sam, also the one thing that I want to know, because it seems like it's been a long and, you know, very strenuous process, but you know, you're here, the ball exists. Can you talk about the whole process from, you know, concept to completion and what that was all like now that the ball is actually finalized for February 2020?
Yeah. So that was probably the most exciting part. And, you know, as we've done this rules, it's been this build, test, repeat process using the lean startup method. For those that don't know, the lean startup method is saying don't spend 40 years in a lab creating something before you release to the public. This was bring it to the customer, the user base, at MVP, a minimum viable product, and test it real time. Have them use it. Have them be able to, you know, try and perform with it, and then they'll give you notes back and iterate. So we first had the first iteration of the ball go from design phase to performance phase at the Spring League in Austin. And we never played a game with it. We just wanted to fit it in, have quarterbacks give us notes on it. That had red and blue laces. And then it was a brown leather ball at the time. And there was a very deep imprinted X into the ball. And so it was rough. It would have messed with the player's hands over time because it was too imprinted. So then we went to a more production phase, added the white laces because we actually hadn't figured out how to do that yet. A team issue, and our team was still working on it. And then we went to the first showcase, and we had the lighter leather, the non-tanned leather, and then a thinner ball. And then we got a lot of notes on that. We were not ready to play football that week. Let's put it that way. And we charted every throw and interviewed every wide receiver and quarterback at every showcase. Getting that data, we would then provide notes to team issue on Sunday. Tuesday, they would have production balls that they would send us on Thursday. We'd game prep them before the showcase to then ultimately throw them that Saturday and Sunday, or that Friday and Saturday. So that's when we did this process. Every week, we were sending notes and creating new prototypes for each summer showcase. So it was a really cool process to go into that to really get to the final. I think the final version of the final prototype we actually had at TSL in Mission Viejo, and it was a really cool moment. I remember opening the box, and we were not in a great place with the ball. Opening the box, the first time I held it in my hands, I was like, this is it. We are there. And it is because we had the same circumference or length and width of the ball, but how we got from the width down to the point of the ball, it was too thin. And it actually was able to increase around where you normally have a typical stripe of the ball, increase that area, that bladder, that side of the ball. And that was that moment where I was like, okay, we have it. It was this one ball. We were able to put it in. And then we actually have, I have on my desk now, the final prototype we used, and we played a full game with it back in Mishviejo at the end of July. So before we had ever announced the ball, we had actually played full complete games with the ball and the exact ball. So we didn't have the XFL logo on some of them. We didn't have the tips on some of them when we were testing different things to get it really quickly. But we actually have played five total or six total quarters with the XFL football before.
That's amazing, Sam. I love the glimpse into the whole process there. That I just kind of picture you standing there in Mission Viejo holding a box with a glowing light coming out of it, with you maybe wearing an Indiana Jones hat or something. That's what that sounds like. Yeah. It's amazing.
No, it was very Pulp Fiction esque, and I think you know,
I was gonna say Pulp Fiction.
We're all football nerds here, so we can all kind of relate to that moment.
Love
where
it.
I was like, oh my god, because you know, we were not fully convinced that we weren't going to commit to anything unless it performed, unless our players really liked it, unless our players felt confident that this helped them or helped them in the process. There's nothing we were going to do. We're going to do for the sake of doing it. We had to make sure that this was going to perform. And so when we finally had that breakthrough, it was awesome.
And I'm looking at all sorts of photos of the balls yet. I haven't gotten one in my hands yet, but this X Pebble technology grip is really interesting me here, Sam. It looks like these are going to be, pretty easy to hold on to, maybe catch. Is it fumble proof then? Is this like a ball hack or something? Are the offensive players going to enjoy the ball a lot more than defensive players are going to try to be knocking these balls out of players' arms?
It's easier to catch for the defensive players too. So,
all right.
We just hope we don't see too many balls on the ground.
Nice. Well, I'm super excited, Brian. I can't wait to get my hands on one.
Well, yeah, I think you can buy these right now, right, Sam? I think they're available for you to go online and or purchase it or sometime soon, right?
They are for purchase, and you guys should stand by your mailboxes.
I love it. I love it. I love it. All right, Sam. Well, that's I think that's all the questions we had about these footballs, and then maybe once we play a turkey bowl with them or a belated turkey bowl with them, we'll give you our notes too. And we look forward to talking to you again very soon, because we heard there's a rule book coming out sometime shortly.
Sometime shortly, yeah. Keep your eyes and ears open for that. I got a question for you guys. I know you guys have been fans of the XFL for a while. The only football I ever owned was actually the football from XFL. Have we met your guys' expectations as fans for what what this new XFL is doing?
Oh my goodness! Absolutely. I mean, if we're talking about the ball, I mean, Bryant, you and I, like, you owned the ball. I remember you were the kid who had the XFL ball back in 2001, and we were in love with that thing. And I'm looking at these, and I think they look even better, and they're definitely going to function better. I think I'm loving every bit of it.
Oh yeah, no, definitely. This the ball. I have to get like all eight of them, I feel like, because it's just so they're so cool and so unique, and that's kind of what you want from the league, right, Sam? It's uniqueness, it's different. So it's still football, but it looks pretty cool, and I can't wait to actually see those things being thrown at me with the cool X and the target. I'm really excited for those types of things.
Cool, awesome.
And as fans too, Sam, we got to tell you, we're perusing on the on the Football Advisory Network too, interacting with people there. Like this whole thing, as fans collectively, like the last few weeks even have been drastically different and more interactive, and we're absolutely enjoying it as football fans, and we appreciate all your efforts for sure.
That's awesome. Love to hear that. Love to hear, because it's really this football league is about the football fan, right, first and foremost. And so getting to get that kind of feedback, we had to be a little hush hush about it. You can go through Instagram and see a little bit of the product development, see a lot of different versions of the ball, but now really being able to like talk to fans and hear what they have to say about it, it's pretty exciting.
Sam Schwartzstein, thanks as always, man. We appreciate your time, and we look forward to talking to you when that rule book comes out, and maybe we'll play some catch with these new footballs sometime during the season.
Awesome. Have a good one.
Thanks for watching and listening, XFL fans. Don't forget to tell us what you think in the comments below, or even better, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things XFL. Check out some of our other videos and follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook @XFL Show. This is The XFL Show, is a production of Pretty Easy Podcasts.